It's about that time, ladies and gentlemen. We are back once again with our yearly predictions video to see who advances on to the next rounds and who will raise the title in Phoenix to become the 2024 NASCAR Cup Series champion. What's up, everyone? My name is Jet. Hope you're having a wonderful day. And yes, this video is going to go out either tonight or Saturday night, right before the first race of the playoffs at Atlanta. Excited to see how that goes. But of course, before we get into that, let's see what I think is going to happen in this year's playoffs. Let's first start off, of course, with how the playoff grid looks heading into Atlanta. Now, Tyler Reddick, he won the regular season title, beating Kyle Larson by just one single point. However, he is not the top seed. No siree. That goes to Kyle Larson, still in the 5 car, who holds a 35-point advantage over the cut line. Second place is Christopher Bell at 27, Tyler Reddick at 23, Byron at plus 17, Ryan Blaney at plus 13, Denny Hamlin at plus 10, Chase Elliott at plus 9, and then Brad Keselowski at plus 3, Logano and teammate Cindric at plus 2 apiece, Daniel Suarez just 1 point above, and Alex Bowman in a 3-way tie for that final spot ahead of Chase Briscoe and Harrison Byrne, with Ty Gibbs and Marchick Jr. rounding out the field, each sitting at minus one. Now for this year, the NASCAR playoffs hasn't changed just much except for the round of 16. The round of 8 remains the same, being Las Vegas, Homestead, and Martinsville. The round of 12, on the other hand, has a bit different feel to it. Texas is no longer in the playoffs, but it is occupied by Kansas, Talladega, and Charlotte. But the big change is the opening round, the round of 16. Originally, it was 3 pretty interesting but normal-sized tracks: Darlington, Kansas, and Bristol. But like I said, we're starting out at Atlanta, then going to the road course at Watkins Glen before ending the round of 16 at the night race at Bristol in Tennessee. So let's not waste any time and take a look at what our 2024 playoff grid looks like. So you see there the drivers on the left side of your screen there. Now, let's go over the drivers that I automatically think will be in with ease. I got Kyle Larson, Tyler Reddick, Chase Elliott, Christopher Bell, Denny Hamlin, and William Byron. I think those drivers will be safe. I think they'll be good. You know, I should say this, outside of really Larson, Reddick, Byron, and Bell, they're really the only drivers that have somewhat of a cushion. You can even maybe pencil in Ryan Blaney at plus 13, but still, I feel like those top 4 drivers are the only ones that can at least afford to slip up a little bit, especially for a wild card race like Atlanta. Now, I do have Ryan Blaney in. I do think he's going to advance in the round of 12. We're going to talk about him in a little bit. And I also have Ty Gibbs advancing. But you notice, on the top part of the screen, no one's in yet. I have Larson advancing, but I don't have him as a number one seed. I think Joey Logano is going to advance to the round of 12 with a win at Atlanta. He has won at Atlanta in the past, won in March of 2022, and Ford as a whole, they have known to be extremely well on the drafting tracks. So because of that, granted, 2 of the 3 drafting tracks this season have been won by Chevrolet drivers, it's been the Fords that I feel like have been the most strong on terms of those drafting type of tracks like Atlanta. And I think Joe Logano would use his experience to his advantage, and I see him advancing into the round of 12 on that merit. Now, let's talk about some drivers that automatically I have been eliminated. Harrison Burton. No way in hell he's advancing to the round of 16. If he is, I will do something very drastic, but I know he's not going to. There's no way. So I have him out. I also have Daniel Suarez out. Now, to be fair, in the last 10 or so races, he has been putting up some really solid numbers. However, you saw his positioning in the playoff grid. He's only 1 point above the cut line. And I don't think, we're talking about advancing to the top 12. It's one thing to win a race. It's another thing to advance. And I think the 99 car, trackhouse as a whole, they are not there. They are not at that level, and I just don't see Daniel Suarez advancing to the round of 16. So I have those 2 out. Another driver that I have out is Austin Cindric. Austin Cindric, with his win at Gateway, he's positioned top 20 in the points. But again, if we take a look at how he's been running in the last 10 races leading up to the playoffs, have not been good at all. He has the 4th worst average finish among all playoff drivers. He only has 1 top 10 in the last 10 races. So when you look at those numbers, again, look at where he is in points. He's only 2 points above. It's one thing to make it to the top 16. It's another thing to make it to the top 12. That is when you're starting to get into, you know, the real nitty gritty of trying to go up against the big dogs like Reddick, like Byron, like, you know, Larson and those drivers like that. I just don't see the speed out of the 2 car. It's kind of like with the 99 car. I think they'll put up good fights, but I don't see them advancing. Now, this driver I have being eliminated because of how this playoff is structured. We're going to a road course or a super speedway at Atlanta, then a road course at Watkins Glen, and then a short track. Unpredictable. Because of that, I do feel like that a top driver will not advance. A top 10 driver will not advance to the next round, and that's Martin Truex Jr. I have him eliminated in the round of 16. I know it sounds crazy, but when you take a look at how the last 9 races, we're not including Daytona, but look at how he's been running. No wins, no top 5s, 2 top 10s only in the last 9 races. He has had the second to worst average finish among all playoff drivers at a 23.7, and he has had the second lowest amount of points he's averaged in those 9 races at a 15.8, and only 12th best among playoff drivers in terms of the driver rating of a 71.44. Those aren't numbers that you would expect from a guy like Martin Truex Jr., but when you look at the season he's had, he has been consistent. At the beginning of the season was very consistent, but as of late, that 9-19 team has just fallen apart and making some very, very just unusual mistakes. Like what we saw last weekend at Darlington was uncharacteristic for a guy like Truex to make a mistake that early on lap 2 of the race. For him to make such an uncharacteristic mistake like that, that 19 team is not there. And when you go into start, you're starting the round minus 1, which is nothing, but you're starting the playoffs dead last below the cut line, and you're going to Atlanta, something that Truex has never done in his entire Cup Series career is win at a drafting track. He's never won Daytona, never won Talladega, never won the new edition of Atlanta. He's won at Atlanta in the past, but not this new version of Atlanta. I just don't see him capitalizing. I feel like he's going to get caught up in a crash somehow. On top of that, when we consider the last 2 Watkins Glen races that Truex competed in, a 6th place and a 23rd place finish, averages to around 14.5, but he's had an average running position of 17th, again, and a driver rating of only 74. Again, we're talking about you're going up against trying to make it to the top 12. I would argue that Truex is going to have a tough time hanging on with the likes of Gibbs, hanging on with Bowman, hanging on with Logano, Keselowski. I feel like he's going to struggle with that. And I also think he's going to struggle against Chase Briscoe. I have Truex eliminated and Briscoe advancing. I know that's probably not going to make a lot of sense to some people. But when you look at Truex's stats compared to Briscoe's stats, Briscoe is having a better average finish and is averaging more points. He's good in Bristol and he is good on the road courses, but that is something that I feel like is going to get a lot of people that I have Truex being eliminated, yet Briscoe advancing. I have a feeling that with the Ford horsepower, Stewart Haas is really good on the super speedway. So let's not forget about that. They proved in Daytona that they can run up front. With the Ford horsepower, I think they can help. That will help Briscoe a lot at Atlanta. Watkins Glen and Bristol, those are tracks I feel like Briscoe can run pretty well at, depending on if they can bring the speed there. But I don't know. That one is going to be something that I feel like a lot of people are going to be a bit confused by. But I just have a feeling, in terms of momentum, that 14 team is going into Atlanta with a lot of momentum, a lot of confidence. The 19 team, on the other hand, is slumping into the playoffs. It's all about momentum. I know that you can save your stuff for the playoffs, but Truex was in a position where he had to run well. He had to execute. And let's be honest, he really didn't. I mean, think about it. He was on the verge of being eliminated at Darlington. I mean, there was a really good chance that Truex would be out of the playoffs. That is not a team that I see can advance into the round of 12. If you can't even get in, if you barely just make it in, you barely make it in the playoffs, when you're going up against guys like Bush or guys like Wallace, who you would expect to run much better well, if you're getting beaten by them week after week, if you're struggling to compete against the guys like I mentioned, like a Blaney or like a Bowman, like a Keselowski, like a Gibbs, if you're struggling to compete against those guys, I just don't have the confidence that I see you advancing. Now, again, you can make the argument for Briscoe because that team has not run much better, but they do have something that Truex doesn't and that 19 team doesn't have, and that's momentum, that's confidence. That win at Darlington, you don't luck into a win at Darlington. That showed me that that 14 team and Briscoe, they have it. If they can be consistent, if they can just keep up this momentum, they can show something. But with Truex and that 19 team who have everything, haven't been able to bring it. So yeah, there's a look at the round of 12 that I have available, Kansas, Talladega, and the Roval. Now, this is where things are going to get a bit tricky, but let's start off right with the eliminations. Logano, Bowman, eliminated from the playoffs. Joey Logano, I did have him advancing to the round of 12, but only because of the win. I see him winning Atlanta, but that's the only reason why I have Logano advancing. Again, we take a look at the last 9 races, excluding Daytona. Only one win, that was at Nashville. Only two top fives in those last 9 races. Only 4 top 10s. And again, he has gotten better than where he was at the start of the season. 10th best in terms of the average finish, 10th best in averaging how many points he earned in those races, and an 8th place driver rating at 84.69. But again, kind of like what I mentioned in the round of 16, when you're advancing, when you get into that next stage, that pressure to be at the top of your game gets higher and higher. To go from the round of 12 to the round of 8, the 22 team is not there yet. They are not a top 10 team. I don't think they're even a top 16 team. I mean, hell, they are barely in the top 16 in terms of the full point standings. They're positioned 15th after Darlington. Barely made it in. To go from that to then all of a sudden having this hot streak that Logano is capable of. We saw him doing in 2018 where he was not a factor the entire season and then showed up late in the end and won the title. I don't see that happening again in 2024. I don't see the speed out of the 22 car. That's why I have him eliminated. And same thing with Bowman. I just don't see him being a top 10 driver. I think that team can have moments like what they have at Chicago. They can have moments, but to consistently be up in the top 10 and considering where they are in points, where Bowman is in points, lack of playoff points, lack of support, I don't see that 48 team advancing into the round of 8. So the 22 and the 48 being eliminated, these are the drivers I have advancing. I have Christopher Bell, Ryan Blaney, because I feel like Blaney is gonna be like last year. And Blaney is better now than where he was last year. Last year, the second half of the regular season, that 12 team was non-existent. They are much better this year than where they were last year. And I feel like, again, they're gonna pick it right up at the round of 12. Kansas, they can run well there. Talladega, we know how good Blaney is at Talladega. And Blaney can run good at the Roval as well. So I see him advancing into the round of 8, as well as Kyle Larson, Tyler Reddick, Denny Hamlin, and Chase Elliott. Now, other drivers I have eliminated, I have Chase Briscoe being eliminated. And I also have Ty Gibbs. So I have Ty Gibbs eliminated, and I have Byron and Keselowski moving on. Brad Keselowski is an interesting character because he's not the fastest, but I feel like Keselowski is the type of guy that has that dog in them. I can't explain it, but I feel like Keselowski knows how to navigate and knows how to use points to his advantage. If he's in a position where he can maximize stage points, just be able to place themselves in position to maximize stage points, use the pit strategy to their advantage, I feel like that 6th car is a lot better than what we believe. Do I think he's going to have, you know, turn on the Jets and have this miraculous run in the playoffs? No, but I do feel like that 6th car, they have been quietly just, you know, racing there. He's positioned 8th in the regular season standings, which is higher than Bowman and higher than Gibbs, higher than Logano. But that 6th car, they've just been racking up points, but no one is saying much about them. They're just there. So I feel like that 6th car, I feel like they're just waiting. They're going to wait to the playoffs to really be able to see what they are capable of. And I think the round of 12, again, plays their liking. Talladega, we know how good Brad is on the super speedways. I feel like Talladega is going to play to their liking. And in the last 10 races, Keselowski has just been slightly getting better. An average finish of 16th place, but they have been slightly getting better and better. I mean, think about it. Keselowski has been running better than Kyle Larson in the last 10 races, if you can believe that. Slightly, but still somewhat better. I just feel like with the way the playoffs are structured, there are going to be some surprise drivers that you just do not expect to advance so far. I think Keselowski is one of those drivers. So I have him in the round of 8. So this is a look at the round of 8. We have the 20, the 12, the 5, the 45, the 11, the 9, the 24, and the 6. Now, I do have Keselowski in the round of 8, but I have him eliminated in the round of 8. He is not championship 4 level yet. I don't think he'll ever be, but I don't have him advancing to the round to the championship 4 this year. Neither do I have William Byron. William Byron, I don't know what is it with this 24 team, but the last, I would argue, since 2021, they have had fantastic starts to the season. Just unreal starts, unloading wins. And then they disappear. The same thing is happening this year. They unloaded with wins, consistency, off the board. But since then, they've been non-existent. The last 9 races, 15.8 average finish. that 24 car has been. Only four times he's finished in the top 10 in those nine races. I mean, when you're talking about trying to make it to the championship four, you gotta be on your A game. And I just don't see that 24 doing that. They've done the same thing that they've done the last 3 years. Start strong, disappear. And the same thing is going to happen again. Now, they can put up a fight. I mean, Las Vegas, they've won at Vegas in the past. They've won at Martinsville in the past, or in fact, this year, I should say. And they've won at Miami in the past. They've won at all of the round of eight tracks, but I just don't see the speed out of the 24 that I saw at the beginning of the year. I know a lot can change, but again, when the playoffs come, you got to be on your A game. And that 24 car has not been on their A game in months. I would argue since Sonoma, they haven't been there. I mean, it's been a long time since you've heard the 24 team with a shot at winning, or the 24 team with great speed, or being the top car. And to make it to Championship 4, to make it to Phoenix, you got to be in that conversation. And Byron, that team, they just haven't been in there yet. So I have him also eliminated in the round of 8. Now, the driver that have advancing, we're going to start with 2. I have Tyler Reddick advancing to the Championship 4 in Phoenix. I mean, Vegas and Miami. Vegas, he nearly won Vegas, got beat by Kyle Larson. Miami is the type of track that favors Tyler Reddick. I feel like those two tracks, and with the playoff points to Reddick's name, I feel like that can help him advance into the championship four. I also feel like more than likely he could probably win one of those races, especially Vegas. So I have him advancing to the championship four more than likely based on a win. I also have Denny Hamlin. Now, Denny Hamlin, he's been a driver that has slowed down, especially didn't help with his engine, that whole engine penalty a couple weeks ago. Hasn't helped him, but that 11 team, they got that experience. Hamlin and Chris Gabehart, they know how to be able to put a 10-race playoff system together. Now, I do think that it's going to be critical. If they can make it past the round of 16, which, knowing Hamlin's luck, probably will be eliminated somehow, but if they can make it past the round of 12, all six of those tracks, Kansas, Darlington, the Roval, Vegas, Miami, Martinsville, they can win. They can win. And I feel like, especially in the round of 8, with Las Vegas and Martinsville, I mean, we know how good Hamlin can be at Martinsville, but Vegas and Miami, I feel those are tracks that can play into the 11 car hands very, very well. I mean, you look at last year at Homestead, they were in great position to have a really good finish. I think even to have a shot at winning and advancing on points, but they had an issue that took them out of contention, had them finish 30th. And even with a third place finish the following week at Martinsville, led the most laps, they still weren't able to get the job done. But that tells me that with the 11 team, they just need to get some luck on their side, like some good luck, like not have any issues, just to be able to put on a race together and not have any bad luck. If they can do that, I can't see why not. Why not have the 11 car in the championship four at Phoenix? So I have the 45 and the 45 driver, the 11 car. I have them advancing to Phoenix for a shot at the title. Now, the driver that I have being eliminated, I have Kyle Larson. Yes. Kyle Larson, I have him out in the round of 8. Now, this is controversial because he has been knocked out before. In 2022, I believe, he was knocked out in the round of 12 out of the driver's title, I believe. So it's happened before where he's been eliminated previous to the championship four. But something about this 5 car. Number one, Kyle Larson himself. One thing I love about Kyle Larson is that he goes all out. The problem with that is that he goes all out. I mean, I shouldn't have to mention last year in Miami where, I mean, he had a great shot at winning and he just screwed it all up by running into the pit road tire barriers or water barriers. That's the thing with Larson. He is a fantastic driver and he can probably win almost any race that he drives in the Cup Series. The problem is that more often than not, he will take himself out or do something that puts him in a bad position and wrecks. I also look at Iowa earlier this year where he had, I think, the best car and, you know, just got way too aggressive, put himself in the bad position and got caught up in a crash, race over. I feel that's going to happen again with Larson. Now, he does have a big points gap heading into Atlanta at plus 35, but he has slowed down as of late. The first 13 races of the season, excluding the drafting tracks, his stats are incredible. I mean, 3 wins, 7 top 5s, 9 top 10s, a 7.2 average finish, averaged nearly 41 points per race, and a 111.1 driver rating. All but one were best among playoff drivers. However, look at the last 9 races of the regular season. Only 1 win, only 3 top 5s, 5 top 10s, a 9th best average finish among playoff drivers, scores the 6th most average amount of points, and 3rd in the driver rating at 99.12. But it's the average finish. That driver rating tells me one thing. They can be up front. They have shown that they can be up front. They can lead laps. They can do all this stuff. But that 16.0 average finish in the last 9 races have been either things that they've done to themselves or things that Larson did to himself, put themselves in bad positions. I look at Michigan. They had a good car, leading laps, but off of turn number 4, lost it. Caused a pileup, race over. And that's the problem with Larson, is that he can be very consistent, but also be, I don't want to say reckless, because he's not, but just, he can push it. Push it when he doesn't need to, which makes him a lot of fun to watch. But if you're trying to make it to Phoenix, that can also hinder you a lot. He does have a good points gap. It's just, is he going to manage it and can focus on points racing? He doesn't need, well, obviously, it depends on the situation he's in when we get into the playoffs. But I feel like he can be the type of guy that can just not play it safe, but be a bit conservative. Yes, go out, you know, win races. I'm not saying just to be totally complacent, but kind of maybe back off a little bit. And if Larson does make it to the Championship 4, it will be on a win. If he doesn't, I do think it's just going to be based on the fact that, you know, he will do something or the team will do something that put themselves in a bad position where they get caught up in a crash or something goes wrong. So it's a very risky decision to have Larson out in the round of 8, but I just have a feeling that something is going to happen that takes him out of contention. So I have Larson eliminated. We already talked about Byron and Keselowski. One more driver that I have eliminated, Chase Elliott, which means I have Reddick, Bell, Blaney, and Hamlin in the Championship 4. So let's first go off with Elliott. Why Elliott? Again, Elliott, he has been extremely consistent, but this is the playoffs. Consistency kind of doesn't mean jack, especially if you're trying to make it to the Championship 4. I mean, unless you have a massive, massive points gap, but Elliott doesn't have that. Don't get me wrong, was he very consistent this season? Absolutely. But one thing that he doesn't have are those playoff points. He's only 9 points above the cut line heading into Atlanta. He doesn't have the playoff points like what Larson, Bell, or Reddick has. He just has 1 win. That was all the way back at Texas. So because of that, I think it's going to be very difficult for Elliott to point his way into the Championship 4. I feel like he has to win. But I think with the 9 team, they are really good. But I feel like when you compare it to the other drivers, like I'm going to mention right now, Christopher Bell and Ryan Blaney, those two drivers, Blaney proved it last year and Bell proved it in 2022. When it comes to crunch time, where you have to go out and win, do whatever you can to advance, the 20 and the 12 know how to get it done. Blaney did it last year and Bell has done it for 2 years now. I mean, he has, 2 walk-off wins. One at the in 2022, won the Charlotte Roval to make it to the round of 12, then won Martinsville to make it to the Championship 4. And last year, again, won Miami to make it to the Championship 4. I feel like with the 20 and the 12, they just know how to figure out when it is to get hot. Know how to get hot, know when the right time is to really punch it to make your way into Phoenix. And I think that 20 and 12 know how to get it done. The 9 and the 19, I don't want to say they're playing the Winston Cup game, but it's just like they're very consistent. But I just, to make it to the Championship 4, I don't think being consistent can work. I just don't see that working. I do think you're going to have to win to make your way into Phoenix. I do definitely see in the round of 8, Vegas, Miami, and Martinsville, I won't be surprised if we see all of those races be won by drivers in the playoffs and having to lock themselves into Championship 4 based on a win. I see only one driver pointing their way in. And that's going to be very, very difficult for a team like the 9 team because I just don't see them. They're very consistent. They have one of the best average finishes, averaging high points in the last 9 races. But I feel like when the playoffs come, I just think that everyone has caught up. And then that the competition is just going to get a lot stronger. And I'm not saying the 9 is weak. The 9 team is weak. I just don't think they're at that level. I don't think they're going to be able to really rise up to the level where we have to go on Championship 4 mode and go all out, win or go home mode. It's kind of like the 5 team, is too aggressive and I think they'll take themselves out. The 9 team, I don't say they're too conservative, but I haven't seen them in positions where they have been in contention to win and have done what it takes to win, have gone out there and capitalized. The 5 team has been in situations where they can capitalize and end up screwing themselves. So it's kind of like the 5 and the 9 are both opposite ends of the spectrum, but I think they'll both have the same result, and that is neither of them advancing to the championship 4. But yeah, my champ 4 I have is Tyler Reddick, driver Denny Hamlin, and Christopher Bell and Ryan Blaney fighting for the title at Phoenix. So how do their stats look like heading to the championship 4? Well, let's take a look at them. This is what their stats look like since 2022. In the last 5 races, Denny Hamlin hasn't had a single win, no top 5s, only 2 top 10s at 11.6 average finish. But Ryan Blaney, the defending champion, his stats, incredible. 3 second place finishes in the last 5 races, an average finish of 3rd place. Absolutely incredible, consistent performance by the 12 team. The 20 car, Christopher Bell, won earlier this year. Only 1 top 5, 3 top 10s, and a 15.8 average finish. Tyler Reddick, no wins to his name, only 2 top 5s, 3 top 10s, and a 12.2 average finish to his name. So those 4, you got to look at Ryan Blaney. I mean, again, I think that 12 team is going to get hot when it matters most. And going to Phoenix, they're going to be tough to beat, especially somehow with Phoenix, even with Ford, they somehow be able to just figure out the way when they're there. Oh, then they show up. 2022, Logano won the race and the championship. 2023, Blaney finished second and won the title. Ford with Ryan Blaney is going to be extremely tough. Tyler Reddick, him being the regular season champion, the last 10 or so races, he has had the best average finish, extremely consistent, been on top. Denny Hamlin with his experience, but his record at Phoenix does concern me. The fact that I don't think he's going to be a driver to be able to fight for a title. And that's where I see this 11 team. I feel like with Denny Hamlin and the 11 team, their destiny is that they can make it to Phoenix. They can make it to the championship 4, but they don't know how to beat the other 3 drivers. They know how to beat drivers over a period of time, but I don't think they can beat drivers in a winner-take-all one-race scenario. I just don't see that with the 11 team. I just don't feel like they know how to do that yet. So I really do believe it's going to come down between the 45, the 20, and the 12. I think the 11 car is going to be that driver just in the background. And that happens. Every championship 4, there's always one driver that is just there. They just take up that 4th spot. Always. Very rare are all 4 up front running strong, I think. And I'm talking like head to head. Not like 1st, 2nd, 3rd, and 4th place is 4th, but he's like 5 seconds back. I'm talking about straight up head to head to head to head. Like down to the wire. I don't see that happening, and I don't think the 11 car is there yet. I think it's going to come down between the 45, the 20, and the 12. The 12 is going to be very, very strong if he can make it to Phoenix. Reddick, I think, is also going to be strong. But the driver that I have at top, winning the title, holding the Bell Friends Cup, I have Christopher Bell. I think he will be the 2024 Cup Series champion. He's been in this situation 2 times, 2022 and 2023. I feel like now he knows. Now, 2023... bad luck. I think with the brake rotor exploded that took him out of contention. That was bad luck. But third time's a charm. He's been in this situation multiple times, consecutive years. I think the only driver that has as much championship 4 experience is the 11 car of Hamlin. And I think Bell is better than Hamlin, or I think can be better than Hamlin once the playoffs begin. Reddick, I just don't think he don't have the championship experience yet. I just don't see him being there yet. Down the line, I think he can. But I just don't see 2024 being the year. I do think Bell's biggest rival will be the 12 car. I feel like the 20 and the 12 are the 2 best drivers that are going to go into Phoenix in my championship 4. Reddick will be there. He will be strong. He will be within reach. Hamlin will fill up 4th place. But Reddick will be in reach, but I think it's going to come down between the 20 and the 12. And with the 20 car of Bell, who knows how to win here. Won here earlier this year. I feel like he can sweep the season, win spring at Phoenix, win fall at Phoenix, but most importantly, I have him being your 2024 NASCAR Cup Series champion. So, there's a look at my full playoff grid. I have a feeling some people are going to be annoyed or disagree heavily with some of the decisions that I made, but that's what makes the playoffs fun, kind of, is that you don't know what's going to happen, and more likely than not, this bracket will be busted. And yeah, I mean, who knows? Maybe I could be right, or I could be very, very wrong, and this championship four is nothing like the one I predicted, and we could have a completely different champion. Who knows? But regardless, I'm interested to see what happens in these final 10 races. Let me know, who do you think is going to advance, who do you have being eliminated, and who do you think is going to be the champion in the comment section down below. Until next time, my name is Jet from MDK. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. You can't tell me now about time. Do you know how many lines I done pit down? Vibes I done sent down, but we ain't hit the dig. I'll up the market till they come red carpet the kids. Success still the target. Soon I'll be crossing that bridge, but can't bring everybody with me, family only. I got some people think I owe a favor, barely know me. That's why my focus on the road is all I know. I see them sticking close to play the wall.